Turn now to politics, your voice, your vote, and the issue the Republican Mitt Romney had hoped to put to rest the last time he ran for president. A pastor's controversial comments about Romney's Mormon faith caused a ruckus at a summit of social conservatives over the weekend, creating a tricky situation for Romney and his GOP opponents. ABC's John Carl covered it all. Good morning, John.
Good morning, George. The race for the Republican nomination has taken an ugly turn, with some now openly questioning whether Mitt Romney's Mormon faith should disqualify him from being president.
It all started at the Values Voter Summit of Christian Conservatives when Dallas pastor Robert Jeffress introduced Rick Perry.
Rick Perry is a proven leader. He is a true conservative, and he is a genuine follower of Jesus Christ.
Pastor Jeffress, I want to say thank you for a rousing introduction. He knocked it out of the park, as we like to say.
But what did Pastor Jeffress mean by calling Perry a genuine follower of Jesus Christ? Afterwards, he made it clear he was saying that Mitt Romney is not a genuine Christian and not an acceptable candidate because he is Mormon.
In my estimation, Mormonism is a cult, and it would give credence to a cult to have a Mormon candidate. I believe Mitt Romney's a good, moral person, has a wonderful family, but that's not what makes you a Christian.
At first, the Perry campaign didn't refute that, but within minutes told ABC News the governor doesn't believe it's a cult. Governor Perry himself seemed determined to avoid the question.
Do you believe that Mormonism is a cult, though, Governor?
He answered with an abrupt no as he walked away. Later at the Values Conference, another pastor seemed to suggest that Romney's faith disqualifies him.
The next president of the United States needs to be a man, I'm speaking generically here, needs to be a man of sincere, authentic, genuine Christian faith.
As for Romney himself, he spoke to the conference too and tried to take the high ground.
Poisonous language doesn't advance our cause. It's never softened a single heart nor changed a single mind. Let no agenda narrow our vision or drive us apart. We have important work to accomplish.
In an ABC News poll earlier this year, the overwhelming majority of Republicans said a candidate's faith should not be a factor, but 20%, that's one out of every five, said they would be less likely to vote for a candidate if he is Mormon. And George, on Sunday, both Michelle Bachmann and Herman Cain were directly asked if Mormons are Christians, and both of them declined to answer that question.
They took a
directly.
Pass on this. This could end up being a real challenge for Romney. Meanwhile, Governor Perry still facing questions over the weekend in Iowa over his stance on immigration, and he's looking to get back on offense this week.
And he sure is, George. The Perry campaign is out today with a new ad, a 60-second ad that is the most devastatingly harsh ad I have seen yet in this campaign and the most slickly produced, portraying Romney as basically a clone of Barack Obama. Very harsh ad.
That's all before tomorrow night's debate, and we expect to hear a jobs program from Perry at the end of the week. Okay, John, thanks very much.